A high-powered committee that was led by Nandan Nilekani has submitted its final report to the Reserve Bank of India. That happened last month, but later on Monday evening, the Reserve Bank of India actually put up this report as well as some of the recommendations that were made by this committee. Now, remember that this committee has made more than 73 recommendations, but we are picking out only the three most important ones. So let's try and understand what these three major recommendations are. The first one is with respect to what happens on the payments towards digital transactions. Now, interchange, according to the committee, needs to be brought down by about 0.15%. Let's try and understand what interchange is. It is essentially the charge that a card issuing bank pays to the merchant's bank, that is the bank that provides that POS terminal at the merchant. This payment is made so that the digital payment ecosystem can grow and the merchant bank has an opportunity to grow its merchant's base. Apart from this, it has also said, the committee has also said that the merchant discount rate, or popularly known as the MDR, needs to be market linked, so it needs to be determined by the market. So far, the Reserve Bank of India has a specific guideline on how exactly MDR needs to be calculated. It is typically based on the size of the merchant and thereby and also the size of the transaction. So now this committee led by Nandan Nilekani is saying that this charge needs to be freed up and we should let the market decide what the MDR should be and how exactly it should be broken up amongst all the participants in the market. Let's look at the second recommendation that has been made by this committee. That is about the cash in and cash out network, that is the CECO network. Now, this is an important one. Remember that currently, to withdraw and deposit money, there is a specific network that exists within cities as well as rural areas in the country. This could be ATMs, it could be bank branches, this could be cash deposit machines. So what the committee is saying is that this cash in, cash out network needs to be more evolved and spread across the country, and they're specifically saying that in every 500 meters there needs to be a cash out facility, a cash in facility at least, that will ensure that the customers can put in their money into that machine, and also in every 3.5 kilometers there needs to be at least one cash out facility so that customers can get access to their money wherever they are, irrespective of whether an ATM actually exists or not. Now, some of the other alternatives that are available for cash out facilities, that includes micro ATMs as well as business correspondents who do these cash transactions on a daily basis. Remember that norms for business correspondents have been in existence for a very long time now. However, the banking system as well as the RBI has seen only limited success in this because a large portion of the people do not actually go to the business correspondents and make their transactions. Now, let's look at the third most important recommendation, and that is with respect to what the government needs to do in this entire ecosystem. Now, according to the Nandan Nilekani committee, the government payments need to be fully digital. That means that anything, any amount of money that the government puts out, that is in form of salaries or in form of any kind of direct benefit transfer, it has to be fully digital. But apart from that, the government also should ensure that any of the cash it receives, that is in the form of taxes or any other penalties that it might be receiving over the course of its duties, that should also become fully digital, according to what the committee is saying. It is also saying that the government should not charge any kind of convenience fees to its customers because they should not be penalized for using a digital payment mechanism over any kind of cash facility that might be available. It is also saying that while the central government has been doing a lot to push digitization, the state governments also need to do that. They also need to ensure that their entire payment mechanism is fully digitized and the customers can make their payments whenever they need to. And apart from state governments, it needs to permeate further into local bodies as well as panchayats. Now, that is another important point mentioned by the Nandan Nilekani committee. And if some of these recommendations are accepted by the RBI and actually and the government, and eventually people start working on it, then according to Nandan Nilekani's committee, the digital payment ecosystem in the country will grow multifold.